So a famous example of classical conditioning is the little Albert study. John B. Watson in 1920 wanted to see if we could classically condition a fear or a phobia. So he used a 9-month-old baby they called Little Albert. He let Little Albert play with a white rat, and Albert loved this rat. He wasn't scared of him at all. But then Watson would hit a steel pipe with a hammer to create this loud bang, and that would really scare Albert. It would make him cry and feel really fearful. And eventually, after several pairings of this loud bang while Albert played with the white rat, Albert began to fear the rat. So the rat became the conditioned stimulus, and the crying and the fear Albert experienced was the conditioned response. So it's sad that little Albert no longer liked the white rat that he used to like, but here's the thing, it gets worse. Albert started to fear things that were similar to the rat. This is called generalization. Albert generalized his fear to other furry things, such as bunnies, dogs, even Watson himself when he wore a rabbit mask. But the mask was pretty creepy, so I don't blame him. Now it actually gets worse. Watson never extinguished this fear, so Albert had it throughout his whole life. There's contradicting reports on what actually happened to Albert after the study, from he was a well-adjusted adult, to he died at a young age, or he lived his life with an extreme phobia of all furry things. But we just don't know. So we really don't want this to happen to Greg and have him be scared of a bell his whole life. So we need to extinguish this fear.